Good evening. Thank you very much for joining us. My name is Michael Blaze. I'm the founder of Unified Fathers for Life. Unified Fathers for Life is dedicated to reuniting families just one father at a time. We deal primarily with child support and custody issues, visitation, adjusting the amount that you're paying, giving education. We do incentives. We talk a great deal about how important it is to have a father in your life. Being the host, people don't get a chance to ask me a question, and people have been asking me a question, so I'm going to answer tonight very quickly. How did this happen? How did I get into this? I was doing some research with some very concerned fathers, one of which is here. Another one of the fathers I was doing research on is also here, which is OG, and this is his beautiful. Let me make sure I don't get a glare on it. This is his beautiful. So how old is your son, OG?
Well, he's 18 months now.
He's 18 months old, but at this point, he was my poster child. He was born, and the system tried to keep him. They didn't want to let him out. They wanted to keep him and put him into what? Foster care and all kinds of things. And this gentleman was there from the birth for the whole time. Give me my baby. I'm the father. Give me my baby. What? So it's not a funny thing now. It's not a funny thing now, although it was a very funny thing at the time. I should have told you to cut off yourself, but that's okay. Was it for me?
It was from the house.
Oh, okay. You sure it wasn't for me? Nah. Okay, so we're going to move on. And so he went through a tremendous amount of challenges. He had to go through all kinds of things in order to fight for the life. Just cut it off. In order to fight for the life of his child, he had to really, put it on vibrate. I should have told you that I normally do, and I apologize. It's my responsibility to do that. So he went through a whole lot of different issues trying to get this child, and the child right now is doing very well. Manuel, what's your real name again?
Manuel Benito Campito.
I just call him OG, man, but say that again.
Manuel Benito Campito.
Junior,
his name,
right?
Is Junior.
So little Manuel now is in good hands. His father sees him all the time. We're going to get into some of the reasons why they wanted to deny this. And this is really very important. There's a show I'm getting ready to do is coming up, and it has to do with what is going on with the adoption agencies. Are they actually stealing people's babies? And I mean, is this a money industry? Things like that. So I'm not accusing anyone of that. This isn't like the Ricky Lake show. We're not talking negatively, but we are going to talk about some truths about what it is to maintain your child. Twin, tell us, how old is your new son?
9 months.
9 months young. That nine ain't even months. Old yet. Yeah. 9 months. Yeah. His poo-poo don't even stink yet.
9 months. Yep.
So we're going to talk about some of the challenges facing him. I think the point that Twin brought up, we'll call it a stereotyping. There's a misconception. There's a certain stereotyping that goes on with fathers. Everybody's supposed to be a deadbeat dad and such and such and such and such. So we're going to address some of the common barriers, just with these two alone, some of the common barriers that are put in place by the system that really shouldn't be there, or they should at least be adjustable. They should be willing to negotiate, and they're not really. And Mr. William Denson, the founder of
A Father Forever.
A Father Forever.
And see, Michael, now these issues that you're speaking of, what we do, the first thing we do is educate. We are an information-based organization, because we make fathers understand there are choices that you make in life. Mm-hmm. And some choices that you make, especially when it comes to children or relationships with girls or women or whatever, they can be some very, some choices that can put you in a hole, put you in a bind for a number of years. Mm-hmm. Well, that's why we try to catch them at a young age and say, hey, these are the roads, these are some paths, these are some choices you may want to consider not choosing or choosing. Mm-hmm. Because there are lifelong decisions, some of them that we make. And as some brothers get caught up into this, the agencies that you speak of, I'm convinced that there's very few agencies that support fathers and their love for their child. if you go to try to get custody or whatever, whatever the father says, it's almost ignored, not totally, but it carries very little weight in a courtroom. Mm-hmm. That's just the reality of it. So we try to talk with the kids, the younger kids especially, about, hey, this is the thing that you have to deal with, about making these decisions when once you decide to get in a relationship with a young lady. Mm-hmm. And because, you know, we believe in preventive medicine. Mm-hmm. If we can prevent certain things because of knowledge, you know, the word says people will perish for lack of knowledge. Mm-hmm. So once you get this knowledge and you mature somewhat, as well as getting that love and attention from a father or an uncle or grandfather, because, you know, we believe that when you get that wisdom from a grandfather, everyone has a special uncle. When an uncle tells you something, and then when your dad tells you something, these are components that, you know, Almighty God gives, you know, to that child to become a well-rounded individual. And if that is lacking, then something will be lacking in the life as well.
You know, spoken like a true mentor and somebody that's full of love and compassion for these young people and for our whole society, actually, I think we're up to epidemic proportions of divorce. Some of the statistics I read, right, with twin, when I was researching twin situation, you know, several years back, I found that there was over 25 million fatherless children. Now, out of the 25 million fatherless children, I discovered that 90% are destined for prison, and the prison industry is anticipating their arrival. Right? I found out that over 85% are destined for drug abuse. I found out of the little girls, there's some number like 60% will probably be pregnant by 14. I was finding all these numbers, and they're spiraling. They're getting broader and broader and broader. So at the time, I said, well, I just don't see how I could effectively deal with anyone, because I discovered that at the same time, when people have these issues, there's also emotional baggage that goes with it. And each father needs to get that off. And 20% of my participants are women too, need to get off that. Well, she did, he did, the grandmother, there's all kind of other things. So I discovered that my best approach to being successful was just dealing with a few fathers at a time and give them full, complete, okay, well, let me hear what you got to say, and really, really, really get into them and answer their questions thoroughly. And what that suggested to me is the agencies and different places they were going, they were just looking at a piece of paper like, okay, check, check, check. Oh, here's what you need, 2 tokens and stay out of problems, and here's an aspirin. Okay, next. You know, so I realized that it wasn't just that many of these fathers needed to come and find out the issues of the child support, because when you get right into it, it's not that hard, is it, twin? You just got to know where to go, where to stand, and what to say. I've had like a 90% success rate. Not one person's ever spent a penny. Did you? You didn't spend any money either, did you, OG?
No, not with you.
Right. So not one. But that sounds loaded. But anyway, not one father or one non-custodial mother has spent money. So I'm saying that to say, to encourage the people out there, if you're having one of these problems where someone has sent you something saying, hey, you got to pay your child support, or if you have one of these mothers or fathers who's using that child to keep you away and you think that the court won't help you, you're wrong, go file for visitation. And they better have that child there when it's time, because that child is the most important element. It's not that old relationship that's gone. That's gone. That's over. But that child is forever. So we're talking today a little bit about mentoring and some of the barriers and so on. And so, twin, I wanted to, since you know you have the youngest baby now, because your baby's how old, OG?
9 months.
Oh, now mine's 18 months. Old man now.
Well, I got my audience has got to say, I know some of the women that watch the show. And, you know, I had my first experience the other week. Somebody ran up to me. You! I said, what? What? No, she said, yeah. You were on TV with those men talking about fathers. Well, I loved it. I was so impressed. I was like, oh, yeah, that was me. So tell us, twin, I know some of our people are wondering, I mean, twin, OG man, have you had other children? What's your status with that? And, you know, in a nutshell, how would you say the experience has and how are you working now with you? In other words, how have you?
That's a young baby and everything. So, I've been able to get my son out of the system. Mm-hmm. That's been the main thing. He's out of the system, and he's with family. And I think that was the only compromise that came out of my dealing with Child Family Services. They never, ever gave me actual custody.
They discriminated against you.